Hey, Storytime grown-ups. How are you doing? All right. So most of the time when I'm doing my ideas for things that you can do at home related to our Storytime extension or Storytime theme, I am a little bit sad that you can't just do it here with me in Storytime because then we can just make one big mess and clean up one big mess. And I kind of love those days. But, this one actually might work a little bit better at home at your house because this week we're talking about bath time and we don't do baths at the library. So, a lot of these are ideas that you can do at home that are going to work better than what we would have done here. All right. Oh, my name's Miss Lisa. I do the story times at Worthington Park Library. Normally, we all, in normal pre-COVID times, we had a story time that was a traditional story time followed by centers. That were hands-on and related to the theme. And so we are offering these videos to give you ideas of things that you can do at home with your 2, 3, 4, 5-year-old, maybe even your young elementary schooler. Every day when I'm working with my preschooler at my house doing these activities, I hear from my 6th grader and my 1st grader how much more fun that looks and how they want to be doing the same thing. So you can definitely make it stretch for different ages. All right, so the first idea I had, you definitely can do with anybody, and it is making Play-Doh soap. We do usually do this here all together. It is a giant mess, but making it at home means that you're gonna have all of the Play-Doh soap to play with, which is pretty fun. Here, we just send home a tiny little bit. All right, so what I would do is the Play-Doh soap recipe is that I use is super easy. It's 2 parts cornstarch to 1 part body wash. All right, and then once you have it like feeling like a Play-Doh, if it doesn't get there, if it's a little too liquidy, add a little bit more cornstarch. If it's a little too thick, I would add a tiny bit more body wash. But you can use whatever body wash you have at your house. And if you have cornstarch, you do need cornstarch. It can't be particular about that part. All right, so cornstarch. 2 parts cornstarch, 1 part body wash. And then I usually put in a couple of drops of food coloring. Not a lot because it does spread through it pretty well. And it makes such beautiful colors. So you can divide it up and do a couple different colors. And then they can play with them. And in the bathtub, you can use it as soap because it has the body wash in it. It does wash down the drain pretty well. I've not had issues with it. And we've been making it for years at my house. So hopefully it doesn't do anything bad to your drains. And I would definitely make sure that the soap is something that your child's skin does well with because I know some people have pickier skin, don't we? All right, so that's the Play-Doh soap. Whew, that was a lot about that one. The next idea I had is just something that we usually save for summertime, but doesn't have to be. Oh no, sad panda. There we go. Oh, those were sad, sad bubbles, aren't they? All right, well, I'm doing this for grown-ups, so they're probably fine. No, I'm gonna have to get my bubble muscles back before we start story times back in person. All right, so that I was thinking it would be fun to play with bubbles. If you have surfaces in your house that you don't want to have that like film on them, I find doing bubbles, blowing bubbles in the bathtub is a fun place to do it if you don't have an outdoor space that you can use right now. So we do like to do them in the bathtub. Because then I just wipe it all off when I'm scrubbing the bathtub. It works out pretty well. If you do have time to do some outside, if it's still cold enough, you could do try frozen bubbles. You can just blow them and see what happens in the snow if they land on the snow. I also really like doing bubble art where you would make artwork with the bubbles. It's subtle usually, and it's something I usually do more in summer, but if we have a nice warm day, you can give that a try too. So just have fun with some bubbles because who doesn't love bubbles? I don't. It's one of my favorite parts of my job. I love my bubble time. All right. The next idea I had involves this little cutie. If you have any baby dolls at your house that have nice, they're plastic all the way around. They have a hard body. I don't know a good way to describe it. They're not fabric. That's what we'll do. They're not stuffed or fabric. Then you can do a baby bath time And it's a nice way too if you have a kiddo that has a penchant for drawing on babies. You can get them washed off and do a baby bath time. So you can practice, you know, undressing the baby, putting them in the bath water. You can do it in a sink. If you have a sensory bin, you can do it in a sensory bin. You could even do it in the bathtub and just have it be part of their bath time. That could be fun. But practice, you know, getting the whole baby washed off, drying them off, yeah, getting them ready to go. And then, of course, the really tricky part, dressing them again. That takes so much fine motor. Look how happy this baby is. Isn't he so cute? All right. So you can go ahead and do that. And I do want to highly recommend that you play with babies at your house if you have boys or girls, because if our kids decide to have kids, we want them to be good parents, right? So I definitely recommend having at least a couple babies in every house. And if they're hard like this, then you can give them a bath. Also, I highly recommend making sure they get really nice and dry. So you want to let them dry out pretty thoroughly, because sometimes the water gets inside of like where the arms bend and stuff. So be cautious of that, because we don't want them to get moldy inside. All right, so that's our baby bath idea. Let's see, the next idea I had is if you have any plastic eggs around the house. I know in spring we tend to get some of those, and you can add them to a bath time. And usually they have like little holes in the bottom, so they're fun for scooping and pouring. They also would be really fun if you happen to have bowls that are a solid color, and you could do a hunt where they're trying to put the eggs in the right color. But the eggs are fun because they float. So them floating on the water, the scooping and pouring, you can sort them by color. You can also bring in a scooper, like a slotted spoon, and they can practice scooping them up that way. And you can have a lot of fun. If you search again for like plastic egg bath, you can find some pretty fun ideas. You could also practice, you know, say, can you find 3 red eggs, or can you give me 2 blue eggs and 1 green one, and how many does that give me? So you can start working on math skills with those plastic eggs, and they will not really notice that they're working on math skills because they're just playing with eggs in a bathtub. All right, the next idea I have is a little bubble bath artwork. So I drew a little bathtub. My kids said they thought it was a dog, which I found mildly offensive to my artistic skills. So I drew up you know, a bathtub, and then I let her cut it out. And then we did thumbprint bubbles or fingerprint bubbles. So if you have a stamp pad at your house, or even you can just color on a finger with a washable marker over and over again, but the stamp pads are a little bit easier to manage. So to do all the bubbles, you can do it that way. And then we also made a towel, and then she made an adorable little rubber ducky that keeps falling off. I need to glue them back on. But you can make your bubble bath artwork. And then we also found some letter stamps so we could practice sounding out what bath sounds like. So we started with the b, and then the and then the f. That's tricky because, you know, they haven't necessarily learned that T and H work together. So you can work on sounding that out. You can have them write it. Also, a thing I forgot to do is to have my child sign her artwork. That is definitely something you want to do every time they make artwork at home. Even though you know it's theirs, it's still really good for them to practice their names, because that is the writing that has the most meaning to them, is their name. That is very important to them. And writing always works better if it has meaning attached to it. So if they care about what they're writing, they will write it. So you can work on bath, but if you haven't worked on names yet, I would work on the name first. Yeah, have them practice writing their name. All right. Whew. Last idea I had is bath time classroom, which is kind of like with the plastic egg bath, that there's so many fun ideas you can do in the bathtub to extend their learning. And one of the things I always like to do is if you have foam sheets at your house, or You can buy them at Dollar Tree that they'll have like foam shapes and things like that at the any dollar store, like dollar spots. You can find inexpensive foam sheets. And what you can do is write letters on those. You can write words if they're working on like word families. You can write math things if they're working on that. And those will all float in the water. So if it's foam sheets, it's kind of fun. And it's still working on a lot of skills that they're working on outside of school, or, you know, when they're working on outside of the bathtub, sorry. And then they're extending it into the bathtub in just a fun, easy way. Another thing that I forgot to put up here is that if you have any PVC pipes, if you have a pipe set at your house, I love this week working on the concept of pipes and plumbing and how we get water to our house. Because we all just assume that if we turn the tap, we will get water, right? And so working with kids on an understanding of what is inside of their house, maybe if you have a basement and you can show them some of the plumbing, if you have an unfinished part, you can show them how some of that works. You could find videos of plumbing. It might all be really interesting, depending on your child. I have some kids that are just obsessed with pipes, and I think that's really sweet. And if you have a PVC pipe set that has like fittings and things like that to play with, absolutely get it out now and see, you know, how much they can build. That is one of my favorite ones to do during bath week in person, because we have a cute little PVC set here. So, I went on for a while today. Sorry about that, grownups. Hopefully some of these activities will work well for you in your setting. Hopefully they will get you a little bit of time of sweet time with your child, and also maybe a little bit of time to like load the dishwasher. So I will talk to you soon. Best of luck. Take care of each other. Bye.